Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Daily Value. I'm William Wallace, and today we're looking at what is possibly the most searched supplement across many online forums. It's a supplement that's been making waves in the fitness world, and that is the nutraceutical botanical ashwagandha, most known for its ability to reduce subjective ratings of stress. Recent studies suggest that ashwagandha may also enhance physical endurance capacity through supporting training adaptations, namely by improving one's VO2 max. VO2 max, of course, refers to the maximum amount of oxygen that you can use during exercise and is considered a valid measure to estimate cardiovascular fitness. In this episode, we're going to look into what the current state of research says on this topic, the physiological underpinnings of how ashwagandha might improve VO2 max, and what dosing protocols might be required to achieve these purported benefits. As always, please remember that this podcast is for educational purposes only and should not substitute professional medical advice. Always consult your healthcare provider before engaging in any nutrition or supplement-based protocols. Ashwagandha, whose formal botanical name is Withania somnifera, is a plant that is native to India, the Middle East, and parts of North Africa. It's one of the most frequently used medicinal plants in the Ayurvedic system of complementary medicine. For those that don't know, Ayurvedic medicine is a traditional medical practice from India that's been used for over 3,000 years. The past couple of years have seen a rise in studies looking at the potential physical performance-enhancing benefits of ashwagandha with mixed results, especially when it comes to physical strength and muscle growth. However, a more consistent finding across studies looking at ashwagandha's supposed performance benefits, although the overall quality of the studies has been relatively low, has been the improvements in the marker of VO2 max. A very recent 8-week randomized controlled trial that was just published investigated how 600 milligrams a day of ashwagandha root extract standardized to 5% with analydes affects VO2 max, muscle strength, and body composition in healthy adults undergoing resistance training. For those that are unaware, with analydes are a primary active secondary metabolite that are found within the ashwagandha plant. With analyzes are thought to contribute largely to the medicinal or therapeutic properties of ashwagandha. In this study, 80 participants were split into two groups, one taking ashwagandha and the other taking a placebo while following the same structured resistance training program. The most striking finding at the end of the study was the improvement in VO2 max. Participants in the ashwagandha group saw an increase of 1.6 milliliters per kilogram of body weight per minute in VO2 max compared to the placebo group. For where the participants were at baseline with their VO2 max, using the average starting point for men and women, this would represent approximately a 5% improvement from baseline. In elite athletes, of which these people were not, a 1% to 3% increase could make all the difference in performance, but obviously people, like in this study, who were less trained, a 5% increase is very achievable and reasonable over that 8-week time frame. When it comes to strength, the study measured strength gains using 1-repetition maximum tests for the bench press and the leg press. Both groups, ashwagandha and placebo, showed significant improvements in these exercises. However, there was not a clear difference between the two groups. This suggests that while ashwagandha in this study may have helped to boost endurance, its effects on pure strength gains were not as pronounced. As I stated earlier, other studies on ashwagandha and resistance training have also shown mixed results in the area of strength. The increase in VO2 max aligns with findings from a 2020 meta-analysis of 4 controlled trials, which reported that daily supplementation of ashwagandha 500 to 1,000 milligrams per day for 8 to 12 weeks increased VO2 max by approximately 3 milliliters per kilogram body weight per minute. An 8-week study conducted in 2021 reported supplementing 600 milligrams of ashwagandha daily was found to increase VO2 max by up to 7 milliliters per kilogram of body weight per minute. It's important to note that training status at baseline would be a big determining factor in how much VO2 max could increase over an 8-week period. So how does ashwagandha improve VO2 max? There are a few potential mechanisms at play. One, stress adaptation. Ashwagandha is thought to influence the hypothalamic-pituitary-adrenal axis, or the HPA axis, which regulates the body's response to stress. By reducing cortisol levels, it enhances the body's resilience to both physical and mental stress, potentially allowing for better adaptation to the demands of exercise. Two, hormonal effects. Ashwagandha may also influence testosterone levels, which are linked to better exercise adaptations like increased muscle mass and strength, although it seems most likely that ashwagandha's positive impact on hormones like testosterone is due to stress reduction and sleep improvements, which brings us to the third potential mechanism, improved recovery. There's evidence that ashwagandha improves sleep quality, which aids recovery and enhances the body's ability to adapt to intense training. Lastly, some studies suggest that ashwagandha could increase hemoglobin levels, which could enhance oxygen delivery to muscles during exercise, further boosting VO2 max in theory. The evidence seems to indicate that ashwagandha can offer some benefits under some conditions, particularly for improving VO2 max and endurance. If you're regularly engaged in endurance or resistance training, supplementing with 500 to 1,000 milligrams of a standardized ashwagandha extract could be a helpful addition to your recovery regimen. 600 milligrams split between 200-300 milligram doses in a day is the most common supplementation protocol for physical performance benefits, specifically using an extract standardized to at least 5% with analytes. That said, it's essential to keep your expectations in check with ashwagandha. While ashwagandha can boost endurance and might contribute to slight improvements in strength, it's not going to replace the benefits of a structured training program, proper nutrition, or sleep. Ashwagandha is shaping up to be a valuable supplement for anyone looking to improve their endurance, particularly in high-stress or high-intensity training environments. Its ability to reduce cortisol, enhance recovery, and potentially increase VO2 max through these means makes it an exciting option for athletes and fitness enthusiasts alike. However, as with any supplement, it would work best when combined with consistent training and a well-balanced diet. Thank you for tuning in to Daily Value. If you found this episode helpful, don't forget to subscribe and share this podcast with others who might benefit. Until next time, stay strong and stay healthy.